Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Nobody knows you better than a conference rival. A conference matchup to get those juices flowing. Time to spin that ACC wheel of destiny right now. We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
South Carolina. And now it's time for the coin toss. And it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. King has the ball teed up, and we're just about ready to get this one started. And with that, we kick off our season from his own goal line. And he's taken down at the 27-yard line. The Gamecocks offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks. But the thing that I've really recognized is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
The halfback picks up a yard.
And that was the sophomore linebacker there who was able to get in and make that tackle.
Second down and 9 to go.
Ball on their own 28.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. And he's taken down around the 41-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
He airs it out. Incomplete. From their own 41-yard line, it's second down. Hand off, and he's met immediately. They couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage on that one.
Well, I don't think they did a very good job of selling the pass. The defense was able to read the play and come right in there and make a nice stop.
He's hit and taken down.
Perfect timing here between the quarterback and the wide receiver. That's a big gain and more than enough for the first down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 45. They'll bring him down at about the 31.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Second down, 4 yards to go.
Ball on the 24.
The defense always likes to see a pass broken up, but getting the turnover would have been really big.
This is the 9th play of this drive.
Three down.
Swings it out there, incomplete.
So they're going to go for it here. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
From the 9-yard line, 2nd down. Run there as they work the outside.
The offense coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the 5th first down in this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
Touchdown, South Carolina.
Converts the extra point. A 13-play, 73-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 7-0. And down he goes at the 26. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Scrambling around. Allen only gets about a yard there on the quarterback scramble. Him hard at the 36.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
From their own 36-yard line, 2nd down. Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball.
Robinson's intended receiver.
It out, and he's met immediately. Gorman will be the return man. He's to the 40. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. They punch it in for 6 on the last series. Can they do it again?
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That brings him 2nd and 5.
From their own 47-yard line, it's 2nd down. South Carolina is up by a touchdown. Tackle made at the 47-yard line. Played one. The Gamecocks in front, 7-0. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Caught, open field. He's brought down in the open field. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
That brings up second and one.
He's into the open field. He steps out at the 27. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. And he just gets rid of it. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. Throws it in a hurry. He's taken down at about the 25-yard line. South Carolina is up 7. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. Brought down around the 25-yard line. Nothing going on that one.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Gets it out quickly. And he's tackled right around the 30. Tackle around the 34-yard line. Nice run up the middle. He'll pick up a first down with that run from the halfback.
Good running and a strong push to get into the second level of that defense.
Going left on the counter. Has some daylight. Makes it out to about the 50.
That'll make it second and inches.
They'll get him in the backfield.
He knew it was a run all the way. He got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
So we're looking at another third down here. And he won't make it.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
South Carolina is going to use their first time out of the half here. King to punt. He fields a punt at the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
Both defenses really played well so far.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. South Carolina up 7 points. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. their own 34-yard line. Second down. Goes to the tailback, incomplete. To his back, and he's got him again. And down he goes at the 38. Williams gains about 4 yards there. West Virginia is going to take their first time out of the half. Wynn awaiting the return. Wynn fields at the 29. Oh, what a hit. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. He's knocked out of bounds around the 36-yard line. Second and nine coming up here. Ball on the 36. Now he's scrambling. And they make the stop at the 42-yard line. Pass out to the tight end, and he's got the first down. West Virginia is going to have to use their second time out of the half. From their own 48-yard line, first down. Got a receiver, and he dropped it.
That makes it second and 10.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And it's caught. And he's taken down at the 37-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
The cavalry's coming. He picks it up. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Now he tries to buy some time. Decides to slide. He scrambled. And they got him.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. He fires left side. And it's picked off. Here he goes. Well, we're headed to halftime now. We're seeing two defenses that don't want to give an inch. South Carolina in front, 7-0.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Defense has been in total control in the first half, and you'd think maybe the offense's confidence was shaken. But if you want to look at the entire team picture, David, how big a deal is it for an offense to know, look, if we can just put together one, maybe two good scoring drives, our defense has got our back?
Well, a lot of times when you know you have a defense, it's great too, is you build your offense around it. And when I say that, why do I need to take chances? You know, if it's third and long, I don't mind throwing a 5-yard pass, and if I break a tackle, I get a first down. I mean, don't put my defense that's dominant, that's great, in a bad position, and you can afford to be more conservative. You see it every single year. What do we always talk about here at ESPN? We talk about you defense wins championships, and that's how you win ball games, and you see it consistently unfold. So if I'm building an offense, let's just not put my great dominant defense in a bad position.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good
Well, a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. Yeah. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Is it stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. From the 8-yard line, they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. South Carolina's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
They go with a run, tackled for a loss.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 25.
Hey, pick your game up. Set. And Boston. And Boston.
They'll bring him down around the 22-yard line. Their own 22-yard line. Third down. He wants it all. Going long. Can't connect. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. He's taken down at the 45-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. South Carolina is up a score. And they got it.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 57.
Down. Blue 80. Good.
They keep it on the ground with the tailback. Nice run there. Williams picks up 5 with the carry.
Scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
First and 10. Ball on the 32. Out here. Campbell picks him up around 7 yards with that catch. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. South Carolina is up by a touchdown. Gains his way to the 16-yard line.
Man, left.
And he makes it out to about the 14-yard line.
Gain 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
Second and eight coming up here. Ball on the 14. Converts the extra point. It was a 7-play, 46-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he'll return this one from the 7. Brought down at the 32-yard line.
Brad, as good as this defense has looked, I'm not necessarily surprised by this shutout. I mean, you and I were there on Wednesday watching this team practice, and when this first-team defense goes against their own first-team offense in a practice, sometimes it's actually better than the game itself. So they prepared themselves very well to have this kind of game.
Big opening. He's tackled at the 40-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
And that tackle very well could have saved the touchdown. Fires quickly to the tight end. There's a very impressive open field tackle. But he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Screen to the back, no good. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. Looks left, finding his tailback. Tackle made around the 28-yard line. Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense.
That's a big-time stop here by the defense. I know we're only in week one, but this defense looks like they're in midseason form.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Toss left, and he stopped in his tracks.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
That makes it second and 14.
We've got a second and 14. Ball on the 25-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. On the throw, incomplete pass.
And that is the intention of receiving on the ball. That brings up third and 14.
He sails it long. He got it. He's taken down around the 33-yard line. That's the end of 3 quarters of play, and this one's a little tighter than the experts thought. South Carolina is in front by 14. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. He's still on his feet. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That brings him second and five.
from the 27-yard line. It's second down.
Good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 18. The 10. Touchdown, Gamecocks. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
And he hits the PAT. Sends this one deep. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
The Gamecocks have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it's set up their offense to be able to score points.
They're set to go for another round. He's going to be sacked for a loss. Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation. Man, and they take him down immediately.
Gain of 6 yards. That makes it third and 15.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Tackle around the 21-yard line. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Take over on downs.
Great play there by the D. It's early in the season, but they showed they don't get rattled at all. I give them a lot of credit.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. And they hit him in the backfield.
Loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
From the 23-yard line, it's second down. Just over 2 minutes in the game. Nice run there as they work the outside. Out to the tight end, but it's incomplete.
Number 82 was the intended receiver on the play.
So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. kicks away, and he's got it.
That's a good feeling for the kicker and his teammates to know he's put this game out of reach.
South Carolina gets set to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Last time out, the offense wasn't able to convert on fourth down.
Brad, this offense, the last time they were out there, went for it on fourth down and came up short. And I'm all for being aggressive, but I really think you've got to be smart when it comes to when to go for it on fourth down and when to punt and try to affect field position. Let's see if this offensive coordinator and play caller has learned from some of his mistakes in the past.
First down.
Throws to the receiver, incomplete. And he misses his wide receiver there.
Yeah, you're right. This is an area that he's worked so hard to improve since day one. The accuracy of his throws, he's improved. As you can see, he's upset here with himself.
The sub package in there defensively in this five wide receiver set. Throws it in a hurry. And he's tackled at the 23. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, this is a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Just over a minute in the fourth quarter.
Check three.
Make look out, and he's taken down at about the 13. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And they make the stop around the 13-yard line. The Mountaineers taking their first time out of the half. It's second and nine. Ball on the 13-yard line. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Slings it. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked out after a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Complete touchdown. And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. So with less than a minute to go in the fourth quarter, the score is South Carolina 24, West Virginia 8. They keep the football, and they're only down two scores.
I thought they were out of this football game, but they're really starting to make this game interesting.
Nothing left here except to see the clock hit zero. A comeback is just not happening.
Under a minute left in the game.
He steps up. He flings it. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid fundamental pass defense.
From their own 42-yard line, second down. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. West Virginia is going to have to use their second time out of the half. And he hits him hard at the 31-yard line. In the shotgun and five wide outs. Well, that one should do it. A fourth down stop here late in the fourth quarter, and that should be the nail in the coffin in this game. They don't pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands.
That's a big-time stop here by the defense. I know we're only in week one, but this defense looks like they're in mid-season form.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The Mountaineers using their third and final timeout.
takes a knee. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, South Carolina 24, West Virginia 8. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.